Good morning, students. I welcome you to my class of English, and I'm going to continue with the lesson Bipin Babu's Lapse of Memory. But before continuing the lesson, children, let me explain you some of the important point of the story. And we all know that it is written by Satyajit Ray, the famous writer. Now every Monday, Bipin Chaudhary from the office used to come to a new market to buy books. And whatever book he used to prefer generally thriller books or ghost story or crime stories. And he was a person who was not having many friends. He was the person that he loved to live in isolation, and he had no one in his family member. So children, when he went to the market to buy the books, he felt that somebody is observing him, and when he turned round, he saw a round faced man was standing there, and the name of that famous Parimal Ghosh. He introduced himself as Parimal Ghosh, and he was standing and he was watching him. Now children, when Bipin Babu turned and looked at him, he gave a nice smile to him, he passed a smile to him. But Bipin Babu, he was not able to identify him, he was not able to recognize that man. So Bipin Babu was just staring at him, and he told him that why can't you remember that we have met in Ranchi in 1958? Now, the man had arranged children, Bipin Babu was not able to remember at all. So he was going on telling at that place we met at the Hodro Falls, and so many things he had told him. At last, he told him that in 1958, when he was in Ranchi, he had arranged a car for him to take him to the Hodro Falls. So what he had done, he had arranged a car for him to take him to the Hodro Falls. Now, Anjan, he told about himself that he was the person who had taken him to Hodro Falls. He had arranged a car for him in 1948 to take him to the Hodro Falls. And children, he told that his name was Parimal Ghosh. Well children, Bipin Babu heard all this thing, but still he was not able to remember about him. And in fact, he was sure that he had never been to Ranchi earlier. So children, he gave a lot of things. That man, he was telling a lot of things for his support. And whatever the thing he was telling, it was those were the things, they were the intimate truth facts of Bipin Babu's life. But still he was not able to remember that he had been to Ranchi in 1958. Finally, that man told that he had fallen down in Hodro Falls, and he got a cut in his leg, and he had arranged for iodine for him. And not only that, he had fixed up a car for him to get to Natrahat. And there he stayed with one of his friend, and the name of his friend was, children, the name of his friend was Dinesh Mukherjee. Bipin always carried a book bag at his sightseeing trips. Now children, so many he had told to Bipin Babu that he started believing in these facts. Due to these facts, whatever he had told him, he still was, children, he became intentioned at whether he was really in Ranchi in 1958. Now, children, he had told him that when Bipin Babu used to go somewhere, he used to carry a bag with a book in that bag. And he had no children, and his wife had died 10 years ago. The same year, his brother also died in Ranchi in mental hospital. He was suffering from insanity. Children, all these things were fact. That was the most surprising thing for Bipin Babu. But then still he was not able to remember this fact that he was in Ranchi in 1958. Well, children, at first he was getting confused, but at the other on the other hand, Vipin was thinking ki why he that man is making a mistake, because he is having an excellent memory as he is doing a responsible job and he was working daily in his office and doing the most take and have taken the most children all the responsibility of his office. So he wondered how Parimal knew all, but at the same time, children, he was thinking he knew all the intimate detail about him, like his wife death, his brother death, he was, and then children, so he asked him which month you were talking about. So that month told, I'm talking about October. Suddenly Vipin Babu remembered, he told that in on the month of October, I was in my friend's Hari Das Bakchi's house. I was in my friend's Haridas Bakchi's house doing the puja. He could write to Haridas to confirm his visit. Now children, again children, at first he told that he was not there. He refused that he was not there in the Ranchi, but on the other hand, he felt that this man is telling a lot of facts. Suppose if he is not wrong, he is correct. Then children, he thought of writing a letter to Haridas Bakchi and confirm that he was in his house in October 1958 or not. Now children, but then he remembers that Haridas Bakchi is not there in India. Few weeks ago he had left for Japan, so, and he is not having his address also. So it is no use of writing any letter to Harihar Bakchi. Now, well children, he left the place and still he was confused. First he was in tension that why he is forgetting that part of his life. He why is there any lapse of memory, or already children, his brother, he died in the mental hospital. So he was a bit scared at whether he is also going in the path of insanity or not. Well children, after he dropped the idea of all this, he came to his house, he had a lunch, and again, but then this thought, but more and more this thought was occurring in his mind, because as that man has told a lot of truth about him. So so children, he felt that to whom he should again ask for the proof. Suddenly children, he had remembered his friend Chunni Babu. Chunni Babu was his classmate. Chunni Babu was the classmate of Vipin Babu, and he came to children after when he was taking his lunch, he came to see him. He was his school mate, he was his school colleague, and he wondered how he had forgotten his visit to Ranchi. Now children, he told Chunni Babu whether he was in Ranchi, because he was his classmate, he was his colleague. So children, generally colleague know about each others. So he asked that, he told him that why he is not able to remember that he in 1958 he was in Ranchi. Now he told him whether he had fallen down or what, why he is having such lapse of memory. Now Chunni Babu had seen in his school and was requesting him for a job. When Chunni Babu asked him what his last job was, Vipin told correctly that his Chunni's last job was in a travel agency. Now Chunni Babu had been to his school, and generally he used to come to him for asking a job. When Chunni Babu asked him what his last job, Vipin told correctly that his last job was in travel agency. Chunni realized that he himself had fixed up Vipin's railway booking in Ranchi and gone to station to see him off. Then Chunni also told him that I think you are forgetting, but you had fixed a trip to Ranchi. He was a person who had bought a ticket for him, and in fact he had gone to the station to see him off. Now Vipin children. He wanted to have a job. He wanted to remind him to have a job, to search a job for him. But he, children, he did not make a request that day for a job. Now, children, Bipin Babu became very serious when he had heard this from Chunni Babu also. Now, children, there were two persons who are telling him that he was in Ranchi. So, who was the first person? The first person was Parimal Ghosh. And the second person is Chunni Babu. And being a his colleague, his classmate, he was aware of a lot of things when they were together in the school. Now, children, when Bipin Babu heard all this thing, he became very serious about this matter. He consulted a young physician, Paresh Chanda. Paresh suggested a plan. Bipin should go to Ranchi once again and might get back his lost memory. Now, children, when this Chunni Babu told him, he really became very serious. And children, he went to see a doctor who was really very young, and the name of that doctor was Paresh Chanda. Now, Paresh Chanda suggested him that Bipin Babu told him that this is happening, but still he is not able to remember. Two people had proved that he was in Ranchi, but still he is not able to remember. Now, children, when Dr. Paresh Chanda heard this thing, he suggested him that why don't you go to Ranchi? He told that you will see so many things, like you will be getting down from the train, you will be seeing the railway station, then lot of places you must have visited there when you were in Ranchi, like some buildings, some market or hotels, and then you will remember all the things. So as per the suggestion of the doctor, Bipin Chandra left for Ranchi the same evening. Now, children, he went with a train to Ranchi. He had seen so many things, like he had got down from the train in the railway station. He went to the market, and children, he had seen so many things, but still he was not able to believe that he went to Ranchi in 1958. In fact, he had realized that he had never been before. He did not recognize any building or bazaar. He was not able to recognize any building or bazaar. He left for Hutro Falls. There two Gujarati gentlemen found Bipin Babu lying unconscious. Now, children, the last thing he had done, he thought that man was telling that he had a fall in Hutro. He fell in Hutro Falls and his knee was injured or cut. So, finally, children, he went to Hutro Falls. Suddenly, what happened to him, we don't know, but two Gujarati men found him that he was lying in the state of unconsciousness. Children, why this was happening? Because now he had started thinking very seriously, and this feeling was coming again and again in his mind whether he had been to Ranchi or not. So he received a letter, urgent, and now, children, then Bipin Babu, he came back to Kolkata. One day he was sitting in his bedroom, and suddenly, children, a servant brought him a letter. On that envelope, it was written urgent and confidential. So now, children, I will not tell you that story end, because the suspense, you will lose the suspense. So I am going to start from where I have finished the story. So, children, I hope you remember that we were in page number 65. Okay, the second paragraph we have to do now. Hello, yes, I've got it. I've been out twice. Where? Once in February, near at to Krishna Nagar to a nephew wedding. Now, children, he had asked, children, finally, when he was not able to remember, he thought that he would take the help of Dinesh Mukherjee, because as that man was telling, Parimal Ghosh was telling, that when he was in Ranchi in 1958, he had stayed in the house of Parimal Ghosh. So this was told by that man, Parimal Ghosh. this is the third thing he had told him, that when he was in Ranchi, he stayed in his friend's house in 1958. So he thought simply he would confirm from Dinesh Mukherjee also. So he told him, he rang him, because Dinesh was such a person, he always used to pass sarcastic remark. He knew, Bipin Babu knew that the remark which he will be passing him, he won't be able to tolerate it, and he will lose his memory. He will just make fun of his memory. So he told him that for a minute there was silence. Bipin Babu could feel that his heart, he reminded him, he thought that he would better talk to him on phone. So he told him that in 1958, were you in Calcutta this through this year? That's the first thing I've got to know. So he told him, okay, I will check from my diary. Let me check in my diary. For a minute there was silence. Bipin Babu could feel that his heartbeat had gone up, and children, in the meanwhile, Bipin Babu was feeling so much excited that his heartbeat had gone a bit fast. He was sweating also a little. Why? Because he was feeling nervous. Hello, yes, I've got it. I had been out twice. Where? So he told him, yes, in 1958, in February, I went twice. Where? Once in February, nearby to Krishnanagar, to Nipu's wedding. So he told, in February, he had gone to Krishnanagar to a Nipu wedding, and then, but you would know about this one, this trip to Ranchi, you were there too. Now children, he told, but then what happened? Again, I went for a trip to Ranchi, and he told Bipin Babu that he was also there. That's all, but what's all this saluting about? Saluting means investigating. So what is the meaning of saluting? Investigating. So he told ki why so much saluting and all that thing is there. No, I just wanted to know. Anyway, thanks. So Bipin Babu replied him that he just wanted to know, and he just told him thank you. Bipin Babu slammed the receiver down and gripped his head with his hand. Now children, Bipin Babu was really in shock, because this is the third person who is telling him that he was in Ranchi. So he is children very much scared. He is telling that he is having some mental problem, and he was so taken aback that he with the both hand he got his head, and he started looking down. Which shows children he was really disappointed to hear this word. He felt his head swimming. A chill seemed to spread over his body. Now children, a chill seemed to spread his body. That means he was really in tension. Why that chill spread to his body? Because children, his brother died due to insanity, and he thought that he is also also going through the insanity. So he was a bit nervous. There were sandwiches in his tiffin box, but he did not eat them. He had lost his appetite. Now children, there were sandwiches in his tiffin box, but he did not eat up. He had lost his appetite. Now children, we are going to do the comprehension check of this lesson. So let's start. I will discuss the question and answer of this lesson. Why did Bipin Babu worry about what Parman Ghosh has said? Now children, Bipin Babu was worried about that what Parman Ghosh has said, because he was taken aback to hear the intimate detail about his life from Parman Ghosh. Now children, he was taken back to hear the intimate detail about his life from Parman Ghosh. There seemed no reason why he should tell a lie. Now, children, he was thinking that there was no reason why should he tell a lie. He wondered if he really had forgotten about his visit to Ranchi. And children, he was taking it seriously, Bipin Babu, because Parimal had told him all the intimate detail, and he is thinking whether he had really been to Ranchi or not. How did he try to decide who was right, his memory or Parimal Ghosh? Now children, first of all, Bipin Babu was not able to remember whether he was right or not. Then the way the Parimal Ghosh had told him that he had lost his memory, that he was in Ranchi, and at the same time, children, he was thinking that he was in Ranchi or not. So he was, in order to resolve the puzzle about his visit to Ranchi, Bipin Babu had decided to contact some of his friends who were in Ranchi or who had helped him to visit Ranchi at that time. So children, he contacted Dinesh Mukherjee. Parimal had said that Mukherjee was also in Ranchi at that time and he was living in his house only. Now third, why did Bipin Babu hesitate to visit Mr. Mukherjee? Why did he finally decide to phone him? So Mr. Bipin Babu, he hesitated to visit Mr. Mukherjee, thinking that it would be ridiculous if he had really visited Ranchi. Mukherjee would think Bipin Babu had gone mad. Hence Bipin Babu finally decided to phone him because he wanted to avoid such a situation. He was not able to listen such word that he is going mad. Question number 4. What did Mr. Mukherjee say? Did it comfort Bipin Babu or add to his worry? Well, Mr. Mukherjee did not reply clearly, but he said that he had been to Ranchi twice. He was not sure about the trip. Bipin Babu exactly wanted to know. It made Bipin Babu more puzzled. He lost his appetite when he told him that he had been to Ranchi and Bipin Babu was also been to Ranchi. So Bipin Babu was really very much puzzled. In fact, he was so worried that he had lost his appetite. So now, children, I am going to continue the story. Okay, now children, part 3, page number 65. So children, now I am finished question number 4 and I am going to do part 3 of this lesson, and we are here at page number 65. After lunchtime, Bipin Babu realized that he could not possibly carry on sitting at his desk and working. Now children, after lunch, Bipin Babu felt that he could not sit for a longer time in his desk and work. He should work. This had never happened. Now children, for the first time this was happening to him. He was feeling uneasy. He felt that he was not able to sit and he could not, work. This had never happened in the 25 years he had been with the firm. Now children, this he was feeling. After 25 years he was in the firm, before that he never felt like that. He had a reputation for being a tireless, conscientious worker, but today his head was in a whirl. Now children, I told you what is the meaning of conscientious. Conscientious means careful and correct. What is the meaning of conscientious? Careful and correct. Careful and correct. But today it was in a whirl. That means he was confused. Whirl, head was in a whirl.
He was confused. And unable to think.
So children, first time he was in the state of conscientious worker, that means he was in a state of careful and correct, but today his head was in a whirl. Whirl means confused and unable to think clearly. Back home at 2:30, Bipin Babu lay down in bed and tried to gather his wits together. Now children, gather his wit together means make an effort in becoming calm and think clearly. So he went back and with a very calm mind he started to think everything. Bipin Babu, he went back home and with a very calm mind he started thinking what is the matter, why he is feeling like that. And at the same time children, he was worried, he was thinking, is he really going mad? So at 2:30 he was back to his house and Bipin Babu lay down the bed and tried to gather his wits together. Tried to gather his wits together, that means children, he was making an effort to become calm and think clearly. He knew that it was possible to lose one's memory through an injury. He knew children, one can lose his memory if one gets head injury, but he did not know of a single instance where someone remembering everything except one particular incident. Now children, the worry, he was worried that he knew many people who had lost their memory because they have got their head injury, but he was the person who had, he did not hear anyone that who had forgotten one part of their life. Like him, he was not able to remember one portion of his life, that what happened in the year 1958 in the month of October. And a fairly recent and significant one added. He had always wanted to go to Ranchi. Now he always wanted to go to Ranchi, to have gone there, done things, and not to remember was something utterly impossible. Now children, he wanted to go to Ranchi, he wanted to do some particular thing there, and he wanted to return back. But at the same time children, he was not able to remember whether he had gone it or not. And next thing children was that his friends also proved to him that in the year 1958 he had visited Ranchi. At 7:30, Bipin Babu's servant came and announced, "Chunni Babu, sir, say it is very important." Now children, then suddenly his servant came to his room and he told, "Sir, Chunni Babu wanted to meet you. It's very important." Bipin Babu knew what Chunni had come for. Chunni Lal had been at school with him. He had been having a rough time lately and had been coming to see him about a job. Now children, he knew, Bipin Babu knew that why Chunni Babu was coming to him. He was coming to him because he wanted to take help from Bipin Babu. Bipin Babu was in a good position and Chunni Babu was thinking that he can provide him with a job. So that's why he was coming to again and again. Though Bipin Babu told him he is not having any power to provide him a job. He told him in a very straightforward manner, he told him that he could not provide him a job. In fact, Bipin Babu told him that it is not possible for him to provide a job. But Chunni was not listening. He was coming again and again in a hope that Vipin Babu would provide him some job. It was not possible to do anything for him, and in fact told him to. But Chunni kept turning up like a bad penny. What do you mean by turning up like a bad penny? That means children appearing at somebody's house and he or she is not welcome. Appearing at someone's house where he or she is not welcome. So children, Chunni Baba was coming to his house. He knew that he was not welcomed by Vipin Babu. Vipin Babu sent word that not only was it not possible for him to see Chunni now, but not in several weeks. Now children, through his servant Vipin Babu had sent a word. He told Chunni Babu straight away that he won't be able to see him not only now, but he won't be able to see him for several weeks. So children, his servant returned back with such a news. With this children, I conclude my video here. Thank you and have a nice day, and wait for my next video so we can know the end of the story. Bye bye.